Hello, I'm Johara Singaporensis, a Singapore freshwater crab, but you can just call me Jo. And I want to tell you about some magical forests called mangroves. In this video, I want to talk about threats to our mangroves. My friend Max the mangrove tree lives in a mangrove forest in Sungai Buloh Wetland Reserve. Like all mangroves around the world, Max and the mangroves of Singapore do many great things. They protect coasts from rising seas, storm surges, and extreme weather. They give food security to coastal communities who eat and sell fish, clams, and crabs. They serve as nurseries to lots of different species and shelter them from predators and currents. And most importantly, mangroves store huge amounts of carbon, helping to combat climate change and global warming. As mangroves do so much for people, you would think that people would do everything possible to protect mangroves. But for a long time, they've done the opposite. Since 1980, around 35% of the world's mangroves have disappeared. 200 years ago, 13% of Singapore's coastline and riverbanks were covered with mangroves. But today, less than 5% of those original mangroves remain. Mangroves are now among the most threatened habitats on the planet, and their demise is due directly or indirectly to human activity. Thousands of acres of mangroves have been chopped down for firewood and building material, or cleared to make way for ever-expanding urban and leisure coastal developments. Today, the greatest threat to mangroves around the world is large-scale aquaculture, and in particular, prawn farming. In fact, most of the big prawns that Singaporeans love to eat come from large-scale commercial prawn farms, which can be destructive and unsustainable. To create these prawn farms, vast areas of mangroves across our island and around the world have been cleared and replaced by artificial ponds filled to the brim with cultured prawns. These ponds need huge amounts of diverted fresh water and seawater, which alters the natural flow of water and affects the health of the remaining mangroves as well as other ecosystems. What's more, diverting water for aquaculture can prevent mangroves from making more mangroves. Mangrove tree seedlings called propagules rely on water flow for dispersal. If the water flow is diverted or disrupted, then so is the seed dispersal. In short, human food production is having a serious impact on mangrove reproduction. And it's not only aquaculture, but agriculture too. Thousands of hectares of mangroves have been cleared and replaced by rice paddy fields, rubber trees, and oil palm plantations. To improve crop yields, farmers often use pesticides and chemical fertilizers, which seep into the water and can be harmful to mangroves and the wildlife that lives in them. Out in the ocean, cargo ships carrying fuel and supplies for people are also causing serious problems for mangroves, which can be overwhelmed with the wake from 100,000 ships that sail through Singapore Straits every year. Mangroves like Max are tough and thrive in conditions that many other trees would find intolerable. But human activities and destruction mean mangroves may have met their match. One of the most important ways which mangroves help the planet is by storing vast quantities of carbon, which reduces the impact of global warming, climate change, and rising sea levels. As mangroves are minimized, the amount of carbon stored decreases. Greenhouse gases increase, climate change accelerates, and sea levels rise, submerging mangroves. In simple terms, Max and the mangroves are slowly drowning. Normally, they would adapt by gradually growing further inland, but they're blocked by ever-expanding building and development by humans. Sea levels are currently rising at an average rate of 3.4 millimeters per year, but this is expected to double to 6 or 7 millimeters within the next 30 years. Scientists stress that if this happens, we can say goodbye to Max and the mangroves. That would be a tragedy, because mangroves really are marvelous and must be respected, protected, and maximized. I'll be telling you more about them in the rest of the series. But in the meantime, let's all max the mangroves!